actually brought, since we're, so I'm going to start with the mask, since this whole thing was about the mask. And I brought a mask, but they're a mask, so you guys could see a little bit of the evolution. And you can try it on if you want.
Oh, awesome.
What I did not bring, of course, was sanitizing spray, but
I have hand sanitizer.
Yeah, well, that might work. That. You know what I mean?
Just won't touch our problems.
Put that on your face.
Yeah.
I'm just gonna start with this one. See, this one's actually worn by Davis Gaines. You guys have all seen the show, right?
Oh, yeah.
Yes. How many times?
Four.
I've seen it as many as she has, so what did we say, eight?
Eight or nine, something like
that. How many Phantoms have you seen?
Eight or nine.
Sarah Love Never Dies in London.
Oh, okay. All right. Yeah. So you've seen
a lot. Mine were both some time ago. I saw Michael Crawford twice, and then I saw the 20th, the longest running show, one, okay. And then one shortly after that.
I didn't bring Michael's mask because it's so broken, the one that I have, and I think it's an artifact. Should I fix it? Should I not fix it? But anyway, but this is the same generation. But I don't know if you can tell. See the eyebrow? And see this eyebrow?
Oh,
yeah. It's much more plain, and the shape of the eye hole is much deeper, and we carve out the top a little bit more, but it's definitely the eye. And also, there was a lot of, the original ones didn't even have quite this much definition, but that one has even more. They've pumped up the cheekbone, and the shape of the nose is slightly more. See how that nostril kind of flares out a little bit right there? That's different, and this whole line here, has been refined so many times.
Oh yeah.
And that. But it actually starts out as it's clear plastic, just a thermoplastic that's vacuum formed. And so when it's fit, we establish, like, you want to get it. This is one of the hardest things to wear in the show, I swear. Because you've got all this rub on your head, pushing the mask away from your face. But so that you can actually see out of the eye hole, you want the eye hole to fit as deep as you can into your eye crevice. So it's right up against your skin right here. So the prosthetics stop here, and here, you know, but you have to get the, that's why the eye cavity is so deep, right?
Okay.
Because the Phantom has to be able to have peripheral vision and stuff. So what you'll see when you try this on, so we're like, oh yeah. And there's also partially from damage. This one's obviously been repaired a lot. And I realize the nose is actually broken right now. When Christine takes this mask and goes running around, the first thing she does is she goes running upstage and she's like, bashes it into the portcullis, and then she comes running downstage and falls on the ground, and most of the time the damage to the nose and the forehead and here is from Chris, not from anything that we do to it, but from her falling on the ground with it or bashing it into the portcullis. So they just get repaired a lot, and we repair them literally the same way you do like acrylic nails. We get the powder and the glue and stuff like that. And this one wasn't filed down very well, but then they get repainted. But it's clear plastic, then the wire's installed. This one actually has a wire in the cheek. You can see if you look underneath. To keep it, because they would, they don't, because it's heat, this is vacuum form, right? So it's a thermal plastic. Mm. So obviously when the Phantom's in it for a long time, it tends to soften, so it would drift away from his face. So there's an extra wire in the cheek that keeps it like right tight in. Because also when it starts to drift away from the face, it drifts away from his eye. So it's really sort of also a safety thing. But this little wire, the shape and the, it's I forget what grade of piano wire is, it's piano wire. This is the magic that makes it all happen, because it hides in his wig. You don't really see it in the hair too much. And it enables him to, for her to rip it off him twice during the show, for him to go and put it back on really quick on stage and get it in the right place. But it's very, very lightweight. Weighs almost nothing.
And whose masks are these?
This is Davis Gaines. I can't tell because there's so many names in this.
Poop
goes like that. Oops. Get your nose in there.
Oh, there.
See how it fits right up against your eyeball? Well, this wire doesn't fit you very well. But if I change the shape of the wire, yeah, get the cameras out, kids. If I change the shape of the wire, it would fit